Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? So, I've got quite a big announcement today. First of all, the question that I asked you last week was, which feeder would you like me to get? Would you like me to get the Coon SPW25, which is a 25, I think it's 25, 26, 24, something like that, 25,000 litre capacity self-propelled machine, or the Pecon Bigger Mammoth 64, with a 64,000 litre capacity? I thought, to start with, it looked like the Coon was going to get into the lead and I was going to be able to self-fill the machine with the front bit and everything was going to be easy. But then the Pecon took over. And by the end of it, the majority was clearly in the Pecon's favour. So the Pecon is the one that we're going to be getting. Now that brings me on to my next thing. I am just going to slow the time down a second, because this is going to take a couple minutes and I don't want to waste the daylight. We have gotten sort of this far in the map. We're just about to get hay so that we can do a bit of mixed feed for the cattle and so on. But it's, what is it? It's the 13th or 14th of October, August today. We don't have very long. I think it's about 10 weeks that we've got until FS17 comes out. And I was just thinking, we're well over 40 episodes now, well over 40 episodes on this map, and I didn't want to go much more than 40 episodes anyway. So I know that we've got a few more things that we can do. We've got the silage and the whole crop and stuff like that, but I would like to start another map. And I feel that if I wrap this up this week, I do one more week here on Melbury Estate and get the 3 episodes done so I can do a bit of silaging here. Gather up a bit of... I don't think we'll even bother gathering up grass. We will do silaging. We'll do rowing up. I've got the machine over there with the tractor ready to go. We'll do some silaging here and in the next field. And we'll bale some hay. And we can at least test the Pecon. But that will be it for then on this map. So my question this week is, what map do you want me to do next? I will spend 10 weeks on it. So that's about 30 episodes. And then we'll be changing over to FS17, all being well. Hopefully they don't delay it or anything like that. But that would give us 30 episodes, which is a good chance to get stuck into another map. I don't know how much longer I'll continue the old times map, because I would like to start another one there as well, but I figure I could go for another few weeks and do a shorter 20 episode on maybe a smaller map or something. So the ones that I've got to replace this one are Sandy Bay Redux version 3, which has only just come out. There's a whole load of extra stuff been added to it. It's got extra crops. It's got rye, oats and sunflowers on it. It's got, there's a whole load of work been done with the forestry and the lumber mill and all that stuff. It's huge, okay? There's masses of stuff in there. It is soil mod ready, but because it's such a big map, I won't be using the soil mod on that map. I know that several of you have been asking for me to use the soil mod. Personally, I'm going to tell you what, I'm going to walk down to the field while I'm talking. Personally, I'm not keen on using the soil mod because you've got to do so much spraying, and it gets to the point where you've got to do all the spraying of, and like fertilizer and sowing seeds and that, you sort of do a bit of that off camera anyway. But you get so much spraying and everything that you need to do with the soil mod that you end up having to do half the game off camera. And I feel that kind of defeats the whole point of it. You know, you want to be able to do the stuff for people to see. So I'm not keen on soil mod, but if more of you want it than don't want it, then obviously I will use it. It's just not going to be every series. I can... that's all I'll have to say about it. So, the Sandy Bay, we won't be using soil mod on. Thornton Farm, that's soil mod ready, and that's the one that I would use soil mod on if that's the one you pick. Or there's Higher Hills, version 2.3, and that is the one of the staff favourites over on FSUK, and I think that the map looks pretty good. I quite like the look of it. I like the layout of it. It's got a really nice feel. I am going to try and influence this, because obviously I'm the one that's going to be playing it for the next 10 weeks, next 30 episodes. My own personal preference would be Sandy Bay Redux version 3. But obviously, it is your vote, it is your game. I will provide a link for each of these maps in the comment section down below. So if you want to take a closer look at them and have a look through, see what they've got to offer, watch the intro videos, that sort of thing, then you can. Otherwise, just, you know, say the first one that grabs you. So remember, Sandy Bay Redux version 3 has just been updated. It's huge. It looks fantastic. That's my personal preference. That won't be using soil mod. Thornton Farm, we would use soil mod if we use Thornton Farm, again, is a brilliant map. Or Higher Hills version 2.3, which is actually an old 2011 map that has been updated to 2015. There's a lot of work been done on it, and like I said, it's an FSUK staff favourite. So that is that's that. It's your vote, it's your game. Head down below. Let me know which one you want, and we will start on that next week. So this is the final week of Melbury Estate. One more thing before I go, before I get stuck into this. I was talking about you know, the lever, you push it for the further forward you push the lever, the faster the machine goes. Combines, very often new combines now, they come with that, and this Fendt comes with it, and I could not remember it. Varinki, one of my fans, has put in the comment section, just reminding me what it is. It is the hydrostatic transmission. Of course it is. I think I've even talked about hydrostatic transmission in previous episodes. So thank you very much, Varinki. I really appreciate you reminding me of that. And there is your little mention by way of thank you. So now that I have got that out of the way, let's put that back on to 5x speed. And we'll get rid of that one. If we've time, we'll take a look at the Pecon on this map. If we haven't, there's a couple of things. I will use the Pecon. That will be something that I will put with the machinery on the next map. I'm not going to go for the default stuff. I will on Sandy Bay. The other two, I think, come with a lot less machinery. So I will change that a bit, and I'll give us a bit of extra money to start off with, just so that we can sort of, you know, hit the ground running rather than having to try and scrape it together at the start, because I think that it would be more fun. We'll get more stuff done. So anyway, this one here, the RT100 rock. This is the rake that I was telling you about. I believe, I can't remember who made this one. I can't even remember how to pronounce his name. He's got a Facebook page and he does some pretty good mods, does a lot of stuff. So the ROC RT1000. So let's just come up into here. I'm going to just drive into the middle of the field a minute so that we can take a look at this one. And right, so we got unfold the merger and change belt directions, change active collectors, turn it on. So there's all sorts of things. So let's just unfold this one a minute. Right, and now change belt directions. Doesn't do anything while it's not doing anything. Change active collectors, what does that do? Ah, so you can have just two of them working on either side if you want to. And I'm assuming you can have, oh, you can have just one working. So you have like really small rows, and you can have them both working. This is sensational. This is brilliant. Right, let's turn it on. So it's tipping it out. That's, it's going out both sides at the moment. If you put it there, where's it running to? Right, as I've never actually tried this machine, so I don't know what it works like. It's putting, by the look of it, a little bit out one side and then a lot out the other side. So you don't need to, If I change direction, what does it do then? I'm trying to have a look at it, but sort of see everything at the same time. Right, so we've got two moving this way, one moving the other way. Now we've got two moving uphill and one down. Now they're not doing anything. So what happens if I go over it with that? Oh, it just gathers it up. So what do you do now? Unload key 7. There we go. Right, so that's unloaded. So you can actually load it up and gather the stuff up onto it. Let's turn it on again. And said, right, now everything is moving in one direction. Right, that's what I wanted to do, really, I think, was have everything moving in the same direction. Everything's now moving the other direction. So now, right, I think we've got the hang of it. So you press Z to move everything in different directions. I'll just lift it up a minute, and if we move down over here, the edge of the field, that should now start throwing everything in towards the middle. And you could either do just keep going round, and yeah, there we go. It's got a nice travel speed as well. I like this mod. This is really good. And so you can go back round the opposite way, and then it throws everything into back onto this heap again. So you get like a double width. I realise that if you just used the massive great big rake, you'd actually do the same thing in a single pass, but then we wouldn't get to see this thing working, because this looks fantastic. I really do like this. Let's have a look at the animations. I've got to try and drive straight, but at the same time, I want to see the animation. That looks really cool. That does look really cool. The way that that's working. It's a shame that you can't really see it very well. And then, of course, if we go into cab, I have looked as much as I can to try and see what's causing this bouncing. And I believe it is the real terrain mod. It's sort of conflicting slightly with how the tractor reacts to terrain, and that's causing it to bounce excessively. We could use a different mod. There was another one. I was originally using a different one to this. But if I do that, there's other aspects of the map that don't work so well then. So I will just stay out of cab. And I will apologise if that excessive bouncing or excessive being out of cab doesn't really do it for you. But I'm going to do it like that so that I don't sort of spoil everything. I think that bouncing is worse than being... The bouncing is worse than being out of cab all the time. So that's what we'll do. We'll stay out of cab for this. Right, so now we're moving everything over. If I was actually really good at this, I could do it so that I'm not moving the final windrow, I'm just adding to it. I'm doing it a little bit. We'll gather all of this up tonight, and then we will sleep the night before we go on and start. I'm not sure how we're going to do it, because I wasn't going to get in the forager down so that we could do a load of foraging work, but I am very tempted to do some round silage bales, because I have, like I said before, I've never done those before. Never. Not once have I done round silage bales. I suppose it could sort of be a good test with the Crone Ultimate as well, because I think the round silage bales, you can just drop those straight into a feeder if you want to. But at the same time, I also really want to try out the whole... Right, hang on. I need to pick this up now. I really want to try out, working with the forager. Picking everything up with the forager, because I just think that would be really, really cool. Right, so now that one's going to go that way, and I'll travel up here. I'm not getting a full width now. Travel up this way. I won't rake up the hay just yet. We'll concentrate on grass today. If we can do some of this, we'll spend the night, and then we'll... Right, we're going to lift it up. It would have been a lot quicker to use an ordinary rake. This, I think, but this mod is absolutely superb, especially when you can gather so much into one windrow. I'm still trying to decide, because we're only doing 3 days. I want to try and get as much done as I can. Obviously, we're not going to get very much silage ready. I think I'll make a few bales, and after I've made a few bales, we'll do possibly go back and do the hay. And then we'll think about maybe getting the forager in. If we don't have time to do the foraging, that's one of the priority jobs that I will do on the next map. I've also got a few other things that I need to do. The Pecan is definitely going to be one of the starting machines. I realise that is a massive starting machine, but that is something that we will be using. That will be a starting machine. And also, I haven't yet bought the white pickup. I said that was one thing I was going to buy. I asked you guys what colour pickup you wanted me to get, and white came out on top, so I still haven't bought that one either. So that'll be another thing that I do. This one of the starting machines on the next map will actually be that white pickup, the in-game standard one, and we'll use that for doing our drive around, probably our first episode when we have a bit of a tour of the map. Right, doing fairly well here. I'm going to finish this field a minute, and then I will come back to you when we start going up into the next field, I think. That's the last of this field. Just a tiny little bit down there. That can actually stay there, that's just one width of the machine, I think. So if I bale this field and bale some hay, I'll do the two together. I'll bale one of these fields and then I'll bale some hay. So I will row up the hay as well. Actually, we'll go and do that now so that we can see a bit of hay being rowed up. I need to turn it off and fold it a second. So we'll see a bit of hay being rowed up, and then I will row up the rest of this hay field, and I'll row up the grass field above us before the next episode, so then we've got time to actually see some baling. We'll do a bit of baling in the next episode, and what should I do? I'll bale up hay first, then I will bale up some grass, and we'll be using the... Yeah, so I'll bale up the hay, I'll bale up the grass. We will be using the wrapper on it when we do the grass, but we won't use the wrapper when we do the hay. So we get some silage bales, and then we'll try and use the forager for one of the fields to make a little bit of silage. We won't have time to actually finish making the silage, but the silage will be done. The only thing that is really bugging me about completing this so quickly is this field just here. We haven't combined it. I've been looking forward to combining this one because of the pylon right in the middle of the field. I thought that would just make it marginally more interesting than normal combining. So what I might do at the beginning of the next episode is hire a combine and put that one going in that field, and we'll sort of hop between the two, empty out the combine with the trailer on the Lamborghini, and then this one can do the baling at the same time. And that way we can at least sort of cover those two jobs, because this episode is now running out of time because I spent so much time talking about our maps this week and what we're going to do with them. So I'll do the same on this field as I did on the last one. We'll do one round around the outside and then we'll start moving up and down. And I still haven't gone into the castle. I will do that as well. Before I go, I will just have a brief walk around the castle to see what it's like in there. Because we cannot finish this episode, this series, without having a look at the castle. And just coming around for the final part. So the question, obviously, is all about where we're going to be going after this series. And I am wrapping up this series this week. For those of you who still haven't cottoned on to that, yes, I'm sorry. This is it. This is the final week for Melbury Estate. We are moving on to Pastures New. So do you want me to go to Sandy Bay Redux version 3, which has only just been released over on FSUK? I will not be using the soil mod if I do that one. Do you want me to go to Thornton? And I know that several of you have already asked me to play Thornton Farm. That one, if I do go to Thornton, if that's the one that you guys pick, that's the one that I'll use the soil mod on. Or do you want me to use Higher Hills version 2.3, which is actually one of the staff favourites on FSUK? And again, that one looks really good. My own personal preference is Sandy Bay Redux version 3. I think that map looks phenomenal. It looks absolutely incredible. The level of detail that's gone into it. It's been remade a couple of times. There's a lot of love and attention has gone into that map. You can really tell that the people that have worked on it, all of them, and not just Oxygen David, who originally created it, but everybody who's subsequently put in a load of work to it, they have all really cared about that map. They have loved that map and they have wanted to absolutely make it shine. So for that reason, that's why I'm putting my stamp of approval on Sandy Bay. I would prefer to do that one. And I did already explain that I'm not particularly fond of the idea of doing soil mod on video. I'd like, you know, maybe do one series with it, but because you've got to do so much spraying and fertilizing and stuff like that in order to make it all work properly, Either you're doing the same task all the time on all the videos, or you're doing a huge amount of work off camera, which kind of defeats the object of having a Let's Play series. You know, it's rather than it would just, it's more like a highlights point. And I don't really want to do a highlights series. I like to do a Let's Play. I'd like to show you what I'm doing. So this particular episode, I will finish up now. I'm going to finish rowing up this field, and I might go up and row up that other field of grass as well. I'm not going to worry about doing excessive amounts because we are not going to be able to finish it all. And I'm going to get too close to there. Touch that hedge. So I'm just going around there. And there we go. So tomorrow, I'm going to hire a combine and stick it going in that field up there, because I've been talking about combining that field for ages, field 15. All the other ones that we've subsequently sown, we're not going to get to. It's a little bit unfortunate, but obviously a farm, you know, the tasks are always ongoing, and I could run this for 100 episodes and I'd still have more stuff to do. So I feel like I should stop it at some point. So we will try and get that field there combined, even if we don't do any others. And I will get the crone baler going out here so we can bale up some hay. We'll have some bales of hay to move around with. And we'll also do some bales of silage. And then finally, if we've got time, I will hire a forager. We will get the tractor with a trailer going on it. And we will see if we can't pick up the rows using the Follow Me mod to get the tractor in the right position for the forager. That probably be the final episode that we do on this map. And then right at the very end, we'll wander up to the castle and take a look up there just to see what it's all about. Does that sound good? I hope it does. So anyway, if you've enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give us a like. And if you really enjoyed it, please tell your friends all about me. Come and get them to watch me as well. That would be awesome. Remember, I will put links to those three maps down below, so if you'd like a more informed decision before you cast your vote, you can go and take a look at them and really make your mind up for yourself. I'm going to shamelessly ask you to pick Sandy Bay, because that is the one that I really want to do, but I have gone through and I've carefully picked out those three because I won't mind playing any of those three maps. I think they're all fantastic. It's just that Sandy Bay is like the cherry on top of the trifle. So until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.